In this video, we're going to be doing an unboxing and an overview of the Corsair RME Series RM1200E power supply. Not only are we going to unbox it, but I'm going to go over every single of the connections and what they do. Let's get started. All right, here we are again, the Corsair RME Series RM1200E 1200 watt power supply. Along the front over here, we can see the power supply, ATX 3.0 and PCIe 5.0 rating, as well as NVIDIA 50 series ready and Cybernetics Platinum rating. Along the side over here, just the power supply and the text. Same thing, not much here. Over here, we go over some of the features and specifications of the power supply. And along the bottom, contents and just some more stuff here. Now let's check out what's inside. All right, so starting off, we have zip ties, 10 zip ties, and then we have the screws for the power supply to screw it into the back of your case. Then we have the safety and compliance information, definitely a good read. And we have all of the cables. I'll get back to this in 1 second. And then we have the very thick power cable. Again, nice and thick, and it is 5 feet long. And then we have the power supply itself. So we can see on here, first off, it has this little sticker here. Silent operation, how to moderate loads in this mode. The fan will not spin. All right, so this does have the 0 dB mode, or they call it the 0 RPM mode. So when it's not so hot, it slows down and or shuts off so that it doesn't generate as much noise. Now this has a 100,000 hour mean time between failure. So that's definitely incredibly efficient. This weighs 7.45 pounds or 3.377 kilograms. And as you can see, it is completely modular. There are four here, SATA and PATA ports, three PCIe or CPU power, and then three more PCIe or CPU power, along with the ATX 24 pin that is split up in between two. Now, let me show you those cables. Starting off with the ATX power connector. Now this end will go connected to the motherboard. Now the ATX 24 pin connection is going to be on different places on different boards. Generally, it'll be on the right side, right of the RAM. And the way you would connect that, you could see there is a little lever right over here. Then there's a little notch right over here. That's going to lock right here into place. So the way we install that is just push down here. And then that will kind of snap into place. Now it's locked in place. And the way you remove it, it's always a little difficult. Put your finger here to lift that pin, and then you take it out. The other end goes connected to the power supply. Coming around over here, I just have this board for reference. We'll find the 8-pin CPU power. For CPU power, we'll find two types. First, we'll find the 8-pin EPS. This is the 8-pin EPS CPU power connection. This is an 8-pin, but it's also a 4 plus 4. So there are some that are 4 pins, and there are some that are 8 pins. There's even some that are dual 8 pins. So for this cable, since we see it's a single 8-pin, we'll go ahead and just put this back together. Like we did for the 24 pin, we'll just slide this here and this little pin will lock it in place. And just push it right in there and it clicks in place and it's locked. So now to remove it, we'll hold that pin and wiggle it out. They're not the easiest to pull out. So as an example, I mentioned that the 24 pin ATX was right over here and is different in some boards. Now you'll find that here along the side. But then also you'll find two 8-pin EPS CPU powers. Those are generally made for overclocking or for CPUs that demand more power. This connector will pull up to 300 watts of power, so you could split that up into two. And the 4-pin will provide up to 192 watts. So the same way we did for the other one, we'll just plug that right into there. And same right over there. If your motherboard has two and you don't plan on overclocking, you're able to use only one. And even if you don't overclock, there's nothing wrong if you'd like to use two. And this power supply brings two 8-pin EPS powers that are also 4-pin. Now the power supply also brings two SATA connections. Each cable comes with three different SATA power connections. The SATA power connector has a little hook right over here. It looks like a little tiny L, and that is used to match up with the little tiny L here on the SSD or hard drive. So the way you connect that is just like that, and then it's connected. Then you would only need the SATA data connection. And then, like the other cable, this cable would go connected to the power supply. Again, it brings two cables. So all in all, six SATA power connections. Now, less used today, but still used, is the Molex connection. Okay, this cable provides four Molex connections. These are Molex here, a lot thicker and older than SATA power. They're used, for example, with older hard drives, and I'm sure they're still used for a few other things, but they would go connected just like this, right into this connection. So just, and then you would have an IDE cable right over here, either a 40 or an 80 pin connected here and into your motherboard for data. And only one of these cables comes with the power supply. Now the power supply brings four PCIe power connections. One of them is a straight eight. So eight to the power supply, eight pins, and then eight to the graphics card. This is a 6+2. Not all PCIe power connections are eight like that. So it's a 6+2. You can either use it as an 8, 6+2 = 8, or if you'd like to use it as a 6-pin, just hide this and then you can connect this into your graphics card. Aside from that straight 8, which I always recommend to use these, they also include these. This end goes to the power supply, while this end daisy chains off to two connections. I don't ever recommend using them. And if you are going to use these, use one of the two, don't use both. You're going to be splitting up that single power connector into two, and you're splitting up that power. Now this cable can deliver up to 150 watts. So if, for example, you have a card like this, good old 3090, that requires three connections, you're not going to want to split those power connections because you're going to be splitting power. So what you would do in this scenario is you would use one 8-pin connected directly to the power supply, another 8-pin, and then one of the daisy chain cables. Again, using the daisy chain cable, you don't use both of these. You connect it like this so that it becomes an 8-pin. And just plug that in like that. Again, it'll click and then it locks in place. And since the power supply has six, two can be used for power for the CPU and four can be used for the graphics card. So you're set, but there's more. Then there's also the 12 volt high power connection. These cables are designed to pull up to 600 watts of power. That's a lot of power. Now this cable, unlike the 8-pin PCIe cable, this will utilize two of those 8-pin connections for one cable. It uses that because this cable will pull 600 watts. And then this will connect into, for example, a 4090 or a 5090 or a 5080 card, something like this. Now, what makes this cable a little different, aside from able to deliver 600 watts, these 12 pins, like the other cables, they'll just deliver power. But then you'll see these four pins, teeny tiny pins right up here. Those are auxiliary sense pins. They're used for communicating to and from the power supply and the graphics card to ensure proper power delivery. That way, it'll cause less issues. But unfortunately, there's been a lot of issues with this cable. The way you connect this particular cable is, you'll see this little notch right over here, like we have for the others, that we do that to open up. And we'll find that little notch right down here. So what we'll do is we'll turn it around, have that clip right down here. And it's incredibly important, not only that you hear a click for this, now this one is used, so we may not hear it, but you want to verify, and it's very difficult because they're so tiny, it's hard to see on the camera, that all these pieces of metal, those pins, are completely flush. It's a lot more difficult, so when you're inserting it, just push these in a little bit more to make sure they're good, and then we'll go ahead and push it in. Now we heard that little teeny tiny click. Then also make sure on over here that we don't notice any pieces of metal and it's completely flush so that nothing's sticking out, making sure that that connection, even if we pull a little bit on it, is completely connected. Nothing's loose there. So now you see why there's so many connections. So again, here there's six for CPU and PCIe. Let's say four over here for graphics card. I haven't seen one that has five, but I could be proven wrong. And then two over here for CPU power. You saw on the other board that had two 8 pins. Again, you don't need it, but if you're overclocking, hardcore overclocking, not basic overclocking, you're going to be pulling a lot of power. So that way you don't need to daisy chain any connections. You get pure power here. And then we have four SATA or PATA connections here. PATA being the Molex connection, and SATA for your SATA SSDs. So we have four cables here, or four ports there, for a ton of different devices. And then here we have for the motherboard. I'm connecting all of these because this is going to happen. Sometimes you're going to have a ton of connections. Sometimes you might not have as many. Now that's where it's incredibly important to have a powerful power supply. This provides 100 amps on a 12 volt rail to take care of all the PCIe's and all the Molex and PATA, all that good stuff. Everything is taken care of. CPU power as well. So I've been trying to stay away from talking about coming back to here because these cables are different from series to series, from manufacturer to manufacturer, sometimes even from the same power supply model after a period of time. These can change. These can be different. So do not mix and match these cables. You could end up damaging components. If you need any help trying to figure out what works with your power supply, it's incredibly important that you let me know the manufacturer, the series number, and then down here, really tiny, the part number. That'll help me help you figure out exactly what you're going to need. Now, this was a quick unboxing for the RM1200E from our friends at Corsair, 1200 watt power supply. But this is going to be part of a much larger video. There'll be a few more unboxings for it for Joe's build, a machine I'm doing for a buddy, Joe, where I'm building him a brand new machine. There's going to be a lot of parts in this machine that are going to be a lot more than he needs, but there is a story behind it all, and I'll go through it through the build. Now, if that build is out, you'll find it right up here. Until then, you'll find one similar right here. Iggy with ThisBytesForYou out. See you guys.